Google's Core Web Vitals make measuring your site's performance much easier than ever before. In this video, we're going to talk about why Google Core Web Vitals are important, how to test them, and some tips for improving them. Google Core Web Vitals look at three main factors. The time it takes to load the largest contentful paint determines how long it takes for your main web content to appear. 2.5 is going to be the goal time here. Next, it looks at first input delay, which is a metric for interactivity, and 100 milliseconds is going to be your goal for the FID. And finally, cumulative layout shift measures visual stability, or how the user's experience with the layout of your site may unexpectedly change. Shoot for a metric of less than 0.1. All in all, each Core Web Vital is something that Google looks at and counts toward ranking your website. So understanding, testing, and improving your Google Core Web Vitals is good not only for your user's experience, but for your overall SEO rankings too. There are multiple tools that you can use to measure, test, and report your Core Web Vitals. Page Speed Insights can be useful for measuring your web vitals based on real browser data. It provides you with an extensive report that includes field and lab data and the three main key metrics that make up the Google Core Web Vitals. Page Speed Insights provides you with diagnostics and opportunities to improve your site speed and performance. Google Search Console has a new report that you can access in the Enhancements section of your account. After verifying ownership of your website, you can locate and open this report, which is based on how real-world users use your site. You can use the report to identify issues that are hurting your web vitals and find groups of pages that are all affected by the same problems. An advantage of Google Search Console is that it enables you to check the LCP data across the whole site rather than analyzing individual pages at random. The Web Vitals Google Chrome extension is free and helps you troubleshoot FID and CLS. It uses the Web Vitals library and displays each metric in the browser. You can visit the Google Chrome Web Store and search for the app. And once you find it, click on the Add to Chrome button. When the confirmation pop-up appears, select Add Extension. And then once the extension is installed, a square will be added to the top right-hand corner of your Chrome browser. Finally, Web Page Test allows you to gain insight into the performance and user experience of the site on certain devices and with certain network conditions. Once you enter the website's URL, you can click on the Start Test button, and you can also select a location to run the test from, as well as the browser that you want to use. On the results page, there's a section dedicated just to Web Vitals. And here you can see how your WordPress site tests for each of these metrics. Also, if you scroll down, you'll notice that the results page shows you different detailed views of requests made during that test. And here, you can get more specific information regarding which pages and which content on your site are actually lowering those scores. Alrighty, now once you've used all these tools to analyze your Core Web Vitals, you have to get to work improving the metrics that you've found need help. And you have to focus on each metric at a time. So let's start with the LCP. The first thing to do is to eliminate any large elements. So if you used Page Speed Insights to test your website, it'll notify you that there's a specific element on your page that's causing an issue. And if so, you can consider removing it or making it smaller to help improve LCP. Minify blocking JavaScript and CSS by reducing the number of resources on your site that contain blocking CSS and JavaScript, and this will lower the amount of time it takes to fully load your page's main content. Look at leveraging lazy loading. Lazy loading is really cool. It's when images on a page only load once a user scrolls down to them, and this enables you to achieve LCP at a faster rate. You can do this with plugins such as WP Rocket. You can also use a content delivery network, or CDN, to improve LCP. And if your current host doesn't use one, you can try a WordPress CDN plugin. We'll link to some examples below. All right, so let's move on to the FID. To improve the FID, you have to start by optimizing your JavaScript. One common tactic is to minimize or defer JavaScript altogether. Doing so will allow visitors to interact with your website while its JavaScript is still loading in the browser. You can do this by using a plugin such as Async JavaScript. Another way that you can improve FID is by removing any unnecessary third-party scripts. Too many scripts can clog your network and lead to slower response times. And finally, you might want to consider using a browser cache. By making it easier for your site's content to load in a user's browser, a cache can make JavaScript tasks quicker. And finally, let's talk about how to improve your CLS score. The first step is to specify image dimensions. If you don't have set attributes for the length and width of your images, this can cause your CLS score to increase. The same is true for any media like GIFs, videos, infographics. Another important consideration is dynamic ads. Any ads included on your website should have their own reserved space that isn't overly intrusive to the user's viewing experience. For example, placing large ads at the top of the page can make reading the content more difficult. And a third way to improve your CLS score is to reserve a spot for embeds and iframes on your pages. If these elements don't have defined dimensions, they can move around and affect the layout of the page unexpectedly when they load, ultimately affecting the UX. If this video solved your problem, please let us know by leaving a comment, liking this video, and subscribing to this channel. And look out for new WordPress tutorial videos every single Tuesday.